Today, I want to give you a live demonstration of accelerating your data science. We're going to accelerate it without changing any lines of code using NVIDIA RAPIDS. We're going to break it down into three sections. First, data preparation, of course. We're going to load that data, millions and millions of rows in our case, and then do some transformation. Second, we're going to create an interactive dashboard, one that's able to filter and render lots and lots of data without any waiting time for your users. And third, we're going to do this in Google Colab. Google Colab comes with NVIDIA RAPIDS already installed. In fact, in the description below, you'll see a link to run this entire demo yourself. Let's get started. Our data science project is going to use this open cell ID, publicly available database of cell phone tower from around the world. It has the location data and the specification of the radio in that cell phone tower. I have this data locally, just out of curiosity. I wanted to see how large it was. The worldwide data set is almost 4 gig, and the US only data set is a little over half a gig. 47 million rows for worldwide and 7 million rows for US only. All right, so let's take a look at the data preparation code. So of course, first thing we're gonna do is load NVIDIA RAPIDS. This is gonna make our lives way easier. We don't have to change any code. If you have code already, put this at the top. It's gonna make everything go a lot faster, which I'll show in a few seconds. Of course, we need pandas. And in the link below, you'll see a Google Colab link that will have this entire notebook ready to go. Just click it, start running it. And in there is gonna be some code to download and extract this OpenCell ID database. A little explanation of the features or columns in this database. Of course, we have the tower, LTE, GSM. We have the MCC and MNC, country code, network code. And then of course, that geography, the long lat, and the radio specifications. So the first thing we're gonna do is, of course, load that CSV into a pandas data frame. The read CSV function is one of the many functions that is accelerated with NVIDIA RAPIDS. I don't have to do anything, just like I normally would, and I've just loaded 47 million rows. I'm gonna take a quick peek, maybe change that head to a sample. Whoops. I like to do a sample just to, you know, I can run this a few times. This looks good. If I run it again, I'll get a new sample. And everything looks good there. All right. We're going to merge this with a carrier. We're going to, you know, add a little bit of data, enrich this data with the carrier information. This is available off of AWS S3. Again, take a look at it. And we can see we also have this country code, mobile network code, and we're going to use that to merge. So this looks good. We'll go ahead and merge it with our OpenCell ID database. All right, let's make sure this looks good. So we just merged those 47 million rows with this operator information, and everything looks good. We have the radio, long lat, country, and operator. In our dashboard, which we're going to go over next, we're going to have a couple widgets. One of those widgets is going to be a summary of the operator. So we can see, looks like 2 million for T-Mobile, 2.2 million for AT&T. And we're going to let our users filter by operator in our dashboard, which we'll see in a second. A little bit of categorizing those operators. Another sort of dashboard operation we might do, we can see the number of operators that we need to name or to feature engineer, 444. Now we're going to discretize or bin kind of the smaller operators into an other. This is a common technique in statistics and machine learning. We don't want to mess up our calculations. If someone's just a one-off, we're going to throw that into this bin, this discretization bin as other. And then again, another one of our widgets in our dashboard, we're going to have operators. So let's go ahead and take a look at the radio count by country and operator. And there we can see the radio count by country and operator. This is one of the widgets, again, that we want our user to use in our interactive dashboard. Okay, so all that data preparation code has been boiled down into this ETL pipeline function I created. This is just to show us how fast NVIDIA RAPIDS will speed up all of this code without changing anything. So we're going to do this NVIDIA RAPIDS on and NVIDIA RAPIDS off. Let me go ahead and restart the kernel so that we can see that. All right, we have three green dots over here. I'm going to go ahead and run this magic function I like to show that the namespace is empty. We can also, Google Colab has this nice little convenient tab right here. So I'm not going to run NVIDIA RAPIDS here. I'm going to just run this function again that simulates all of that data wrangling, that data preparation. And I'm going to run it without NVIDIA RAPIDS. Now, this is going to take around 40 seconds. What's nice about Google Colab is you kind of have a trace down here of what's going on and an execution time. So we can see that it's 13 seconds, 14 seconds, and what exactly is going on. This is really nice for debugging. Really nice feature of Google Colab. Since we have about 20 more seconds, I'm going to go ahead and pause, maybe speed up. We'll see in a second. All right, so that took 40 seconds. I'm not going to change any code. All I'm going to do is load NVIDIA RAPIDS, specifically the cuDF library from NVIDIA RAPIDS. I'm going to load this function again, and we're going to run this here. Let me update the time. That was actually a little faster that time. I'm going to run this with NVIDIA RAPIDS on, and if all goes well, there we have it. That took 1.44 seconds. So that is quite a speed up using NVIDIA RAPIDS. Now that we've prepared our data, it's time to build our interactive dashboard. NVIDIA RAPIDS accelerates lots of different visualization libraries. The one we're going to use today is the panel library from the HoloViz ecosystem. This is pip installable from Google Colab or any Jupyter notebook. Here we have our import statements, and then we're going to build a few sample widgets. So this widget right here is going to show us the counts of the radio types, and then this widget here will show us the country counts of all the radio towers counts by country. This is the interactive dashboard we're going to build. You can see if we zoom in here, we have all of our data loaded. We have all the radio towers within the US, 7.3 million row data frame. We have a point budget of 10,000, so we have 10,000 data points rendered here. And if you remember, each one of these data points is a row. And if we go ahead and do a little sample filtering here, we'll do GSM radio towers types, whatever that is. And we've exposed to the end user here the compute time to do that data processing, that data filtering, which we saw was 28 times faster with NVIDIA RAPIDS. So without NVIDIA RAPIDS, the latency on this is not going to be enjoyable for your end user. All right, let's go ahead and dive into the code that creates this interactive dashboard. So here's our class definition for this interactive dashboard. The top here, we can see some instance variables that we use for filtering. We have the radio type, operator, country, and then we also expose a date range slider, as you can see with this range type. This is going to be a slider to allow the user to filter by various date ranges. We also have some execution variables here. to expose how long it's taking to process, to use these filters against our 7 million row data frame. And then we allow the user to increase the number of points rendered. We go all the way up to 100,000. I'll allow you to test that on your own, but 10,000 is a lot already. 100,000 is quite a bit. Down here, we see these at params depends annotated functions. And in particular, this watch equals true. This is going to listen to the events. This is as the user does selections or slides that range widget, it's going to listen to those events and then process the data based on those events. Again, we have more of these at params, depends, annotated functions. All of this is doing that data processing for our interactive dashboard. This one, it really allows us to see the execution time with and without NVIDIA RAPIDS. Again, play with this on your own. Just click the link in the bottom. We'll open up a Colab, and then you can experiment with all of this on your own. All right, so at the very end here, we see this view function is where we create that panel, the interactive dashboard or the panel in HoloViz, and we're gonna return that thing to our user. So we go ahead and run this. It's going to instantiate the panel, the class tower dashboard panel, and create the view. Now, what's interesting is this is running in a Jupyter notebook. This is an interactive dashboard within a Jupyter notebook, which is really nice. But you can also deploy this in a server mode. If you have your own VM or you want to do it locally, all of this can be run in server mode or right here in a Jupyter notebook or Google Colab notebook, which makes it easy to deploy this. So if you've got a nice dashboard and you want to show this to a decision maker or something, you can just send them a link and they can run this on their own and hopefully come to the same conclusion. So here we have 7 million rows. We have 10,000 data points in our dashboard here. And each data point, again, a row from that data frame, the specs, the location, the lat long. And as I filter here, we're going to show the execution time. So just like in data preparation, filtering, sorting, merging all that data is going to create the latency that, you know, makes our experience less enjoyable for the user. The higher the latency, the less experience. But we showed that using NVIDIA RAPIDS, not changing any code, gave us, I think it was a 28 time performance boost. So that makes us, you know, as the consumer of this dashboard, more willing to sit here, less frustration for your user. And there you have it. Here's an interactive dashboard using NVIDIA RAPIDS, not changing any code. So we've done all of this in Google Colab. Google Colab has some really nice features out of the box. I didn't have to do anything special. So some nice debugging features would be, I can look at my variables here. Normally, you know, I would have to come in here, create a new cell, and do maybe a magic command like ooze. And you know, this is all kind of time consuming. This gives it to me. I've got the type, I've got the shape. That's a really nice feature. Another feature I like, you know, I can look at my folders here. We can, you know, this is very cloud centric. We can have secrets, variables, environment variables, we have our table of contents to quickly go to, you know, if I want to go quick to that data preparation code that I have, I can go there. Can even open up a command line here, which is nice if I want to sit here, maybe do command line processing. I can see, for instance, that this cell towers data set, I want to look at how many lines of code it is. I can do a word count dash L. Let's see, cell towers, US, CSV, this should be 7 million. One of my favorite features is looking at resources. So if I'm running something and it's going slow, I can see maybe
my system RAM has gone up, or I've exceeded my GPU RAM. Very nice. This is one of my favorite features of Google Colab. So if you want to run this notebook or a notebook of your own, just click right in the description below. This will create a Google Colab session for you, whether you have an account or not, and you'll have all this code rendered for you immediately. And again, NVIDIA RAPIDS is already installed in Google Colab to make all of that data processing, that data science accelerated without changing any lines of code. So that concludes our data science demo, accelerating it with NVIDIA RAPIDS, not changing any lines of code. We got a times 28 performance boost. We did our data preparation, we did our interactive dashboard, and then we did it all in Google Colab. To get started right away, just click down below in the description and you can create the same process yourself. Again, I'm William Hill, developer advocate for NVIDIA. Cheers and happy coding.